second date now for the rest of the municipal year so that the members have an opportunity to put their diaries right, because if this happens again, it might be more people missing next time. Who knows, we might get to a position where we're not Tories and have adapted to then. So, Mr. Mayor, I implore you that if we're going to adopt this approach of journeying councils, that we have a second date pre-printed and notified within the next week for all future councils, in case of.
Yeah, just briefly respond on myself and support. I have listened very carefully to what members have said to me, particularly in regard to health and well-being and that. And members were very frightened that we could have been here till midnight last minute. And I took that into consideration when I heard people talking. It is very difficult when we have 15 motions and lots of amendments and that. I did ask for leaders to get together and try to have a sort of informal discussion. I don't want to impede in any way the democratic process. I want greatest participation in these council meetings and that. But I'm also aware of some issues that people have when they have to sit here for 5 hours or more. You know, and I think that is important. Okay, Councillor Batch, you wanted to say something.
No, Mr. Mayor, you've entirely highlighted some of the concerns and then led you. We have actually had people who fell ill during those long periods of time due to lack of circulation and issues around that. So we have to balance these things up. We need to be kind to officers and ourselves. After a full day's work, 5 or 6 hours in this chamber is not tolerable.
I would certainly commend the suggestion made by Councillor Blakey to the Council. It was precisely the issue of members and officers' tiredness that was in my mind last time, and the time needed members to look at issues properly. So if members' leaders can get together to look at potential dates, especially as the Council is coming up to discuss the local plan or approve a plan or a consultation process at some point, it would be very wise to have dates in mind for that.
Okay, Councillor Berryman, and then I'm going to finish.
Just to highlight again, you have a duty of care and health and well-being, not only for our constituents, not only for members of staff, but for elected members as well. And we seem to have forgotten that over the last few months. I'm concerned when we see the seriousness of the issues the two of our members have. After the last full council meeting, I think we really need to be sensible on what we do. I'm all for democracy in every way, but there's a health and well-being and a duty of care issue here which we're ignoring. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Councillor. Right, I'm mindful of all of that, so thank you very much.